I'm so clean and the motherfuckers just talking. I show up at the spot and now everyone they are watching. No one will prove you wrong, but shit, you leave me with no option. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, hi guys, what's up? It's Molly here and welcome back to my channel. So before we get on to this, I'm gonna have all the product listed in the description. So if you wanna know exactly what shades, exactly what palettes, exactly what everything, then go into the description and you can check it out. So I'm just doing my normal foundation routine, you know, like my collection foundation, my everyday sort of foundation, and then plus my LA Girl concealer, which I need a new one of, as you can tell. And then I'm just using my damp beauty blender. I actually think my skin looked real, real good to this day. And then I'm using a baking powder that I basically just snatched from a beauty kit. And yeah, this is actually really, really good. I've got really oily skin and it really, really sets me. And then I'm just using a pressed powder just to kind of, you know, set the rest of my face. And then I'm using the Makeup Revolution contour palette and I'm just contouring my face. I then get the Hoola bronzer and I bronze up my face. I feel like this technique actually makes my face look much slimmer and much more bronzy, and then obviously it can look a bit muddy, so then I just go over it with a big old like fluffy brush and it really makes it look slimmer, it makes it look bronzy. Now my eyebrows, let's not even get into this. You know the Salted Caramel palette, you know the darkest brown in there, I thought, hey, it's a good shade because I ran out of all my eyebrow stuff, and then I realised this video that is actually red, that I'm actually got ginger eyebrows, lovely. So I actually got a new pomade, and I'm using that now, and I actually really like it. So then, off camera, I just did my concealer under the eyebrows, and then I'm just setting that with the Salted Caramel, like the white shade in that palette. And then I'm using one of the transition shades on a small sort of fluffy brush, and I'm just sort of decided to pack that into my crease and sort of outer edge. So with this look, I really, really, really wanted it to be blended because I was going to this like Oscar ceremony that my college does and I was like meeting loads of people that I never really knew before, etc, etc. And I just wanted to make sure it looked really well and I looked fashionable and I looked like I knew what I was doing. So this whole look is just to look really blended, look very seamless. So this red shade I put on a kind of like a bigger fluffy brush and I'm just sort of packing that into the outer corners and then I'm dragging it into my crease. It's basically the halo eye I did a couple of months ago, but just not a halo eye and just a normal sort of eyeshadow look. So yeah, as you can see, like I'm just grabbing a clean brush and I'm just going over and I'm blending out my edges. And then I'm grabbing a pencil brush, or sort of a fluffier pencil brush. It's not as dense as a normal pencil brush, but it's a little bit fluffier, and I'm just packing the plum color in the Barry M palette that I use a lot in my videos, and I'm just packing that into the crease just to darken it up and darken the outer corner. With my eyes, I actually really, really liked them today, so I just think, hey. And then I'm using a Barry M glitter dust, I think that's what they're called, and I think it's in pigment 10 or something. It's literally my favorite pigment. I have quite a lot of them. I don't even know if they sell them. They don't sell it in Superdrug where I am, or Boots. This shade anyway, they sell quite a few, but not this shade. I think this actually looks sickening, and all I did was spray my brush with a setting spray, and this is what I got, and I'm literally like, yes. So then, as you can tell, I'm just grabbing a NYX, I think it's like a NYX blending brush, and it's really, really good. I'm just blending out my edges, and then I am grabbing another bit of setting spray, and I'm just using a bit of a highlighter shade in this sort of caramel palette just to highlight me in a corner. I added a bit more glitter into both eyes because I felt like they were sort of like going away, and then I'm just dragging that red shade underneath my eyes as well. And then I'm just grabbing another blending brush and just kind of adding a bit more red back in. And then I'm adding a small kind of detail brush and I'm using that plum colour and I'm just dragging that under there. And then I'm using a mascara. I'm not 100% sure on the name of this mascara, but I'll leave it in the description below. It's so underrated and I think it's a little bit better than the last Lash Sensational I used. Especially because I don't use lashes. I avoid lashes like the plague because as soon as you wear them, you start to think that you can't have a look without them. And then the blush I'm using is a Flutter blush from like Superdrug or something. It was called the Perfect Blush, and I think it probably is. Highlighter. Don't even talk about highlighter. I'm having actual proper struggles with my highlighter at the moment. I just can't find one that works for me. It brings out my texture and my skin. I just don't like it. So yeah, I'm just going over and highlighting everywhere that I need highlight. I've got this new highlight though. It's the lavender highlight. I've never tried lavender highlight before. And I think I'm really excited to see the results. And then I'm using the NYX Liquid Suede in Softly Spoken, a nail art brush, and then New Look liquid lipstick in Mocha. Mocha actually smells like chocolate, it's so nice. And I'm making myself an ombre lip. If you want like a full tutorial on how to do this with like different colours and stuff, I will do it. I'm happy to do it because I really like ombre lips at the moment. So this is the final look and I'm just going to set my face. As you can tell, I was really, really feeling myself. And as I should, because I looked bloody bomb. And I don't even care about saying that. I looked bomb. So yeah, this is me feeling myself. So if you want more videos like this, you want more makeup tutorials, give me some ideas and suggestions in the description. In the comments, mate. And if you want a tutorial on how to do this hair look as well, I will be happy to do it because it looked great. So yeah, thanks for watching. Like, comment and subscribe. It has been fun. Bye guys.